Hello and welcome to Apache Kafka tutorial at Learning Journal. In this video, we will cover fault tolerance in Apache Kafka. So, do you understand this term, the fault tolerance? Let me explain it. In the previous session, we learned that Kafka is a distributed system and it works on cluster of computers. Most of the time, Kafka will spread your data in partitions over various systems in the cluster. So if one or two systems in the cluster fail, what will happen to your data? Will you be able to read it? Probably not. That's a fault. Can we tolerate it? The term fault tolerance is very common in distributed systems. It means making your data available even in case of some failures. How to do it? One simple solution is to make multiple copies of data and keep it on separate systems. So if you have three copies of a partition and Kafka stores them on three different machines, you should be able to avoid two failures. Since you have three copies on three different systems, even if two of them fails, you can still read your data from the third system. There is a particular term used for making multiple copies. We call it replication factor. So if I say replication factor is 3, that means I am maintaining 3 copies of my partition. If I say replication factor is 2, that means we are keeping 2 copies of a partition. 3 is a reasonable number for replication factor. You can even set it to higher if your data is supercritical or you are using cheap machines. So Kafka implements fault tolerance by applying replication to the partitions. We can define replication factor at the topic level. So we don't set a replication factor of partitions, we set it for a topic. And it applies to all partitions within the topic. You may want to understand how it works in Kafka. I mean, how Kafka makes these copies. Let me explain that part as well. Kafka implements a leader and a follower model. So, for every partition, one broker is elected as a leader. And the leader takes care of all client interactions. What does that mean? That means when a producer is willing to send some data, it connects to leader and starts sending data. It is a leader's responsibility to receive the message, store it in local disk, and send back an acknowledgement to the producer. Similarly, when a consumer is willing to read data, it sends a request to the leader. It is leader's responsibility to send requested data back to the consumer. For every partition, we have a leader, and the leader takes care of all requests and responses. I hope that part is clear, right? But you may be wondering that in all of this, we haven't made any copy. That's where the followers come into play. So if we create a topic with the replication factor set to 3, a leader of the topic is already maintaining the first copy. We need 2 more copies. So the Kafka will identify 2 more brokers as a followers to make those 2 copies. These followers will copy the data from the leader. They don't talk to producer or consumer. They just copy data from a leader. Simple, isn't it? Can we see all this happening? Yes. Let me show you a leader and a follower in action so that you get a better understanding of these concepts. To be able to demonstrate one leader and 2 followers, I need a 3-node Kafka cluster. In an ideal cluster, we install one broker on one computer. But for a demonstration or a development activity, we can start multiple brokers on a single machine. So let's do it. I already started a Kafka cluster with my first broker in an earlier video. Now I am going to start 2 more brokers on the same machine. I hope you remember the command line tool that we used to start a Kafka broker. We used Kafka server start.sh. And we pass the server.properties file as a parameter to the tool. We will follow the same method to start 2 more brokers. But before that, we will make a copy of the broker config file and modify it. That's necessary to start new brokers. We can't start multiple brokers using same properties. So let's make two more copies of the original properties file and modify them. Then we will use these modified files to start two more brokers. Okay, so now I have two more property files. Now I want to change three properties in these files. Let me explain those properties and then we will go ahead and modify them. The first property is broker ID. It is a unique identifier for the broker. The default value for the first broker is 0. So we will change it to 1 for the second broker and 2 for the third broker. We are changing it to provide a unique identification to each broker. The next property is the broker port. It is a network port number to which broker will bind itself. The broker will use this port number to communicate with producers and consumers. We will just increment it to whatever the default value is there. In fact, when you start brokers on separate machines, you don't need to change this port number. But since we are starting them on a single machine, we need to change it. Otherwise, all brokers will start reading and writing on the same port number. The third property is broker log directory. The broker log directory is the main data directory of a broker. We don't want all of the brokers to write into the same directory. So we need to change this value as well. Okay, so let me go ahead and modify these properties in the files and prepare a new file for my other two brokers. Good. So now I have both the files. Let me start two more brokers. Okay, so I have a 3-node Kafka cluster up and running. We did all of this because I wanted to create a topic with a replication factor 3 and show you the leader and the follower for each partition. So let's do that. You already know how to create a topic. Okay, so the topic is created. This command line tool is the best available method as on today to manage a Kafka topic. We call it topic management tool. So the Kafka topic management tool also provides a describe command. Let me show you. So you see this? It shows you the topic name. Then it tells you the number of partitions in this topic. It shows replication factor for the topic. It tells everything that you want to know about a topic. Since we have two partitions on this topic, it displays two rows, one for each partition. This one is the partition ID. So the ID for the first partition is 0 and it is 1 for the second partition. The next information is the leader. So for the first partition, broker 1 is the leader. What does that mean? That means that the broker 1 will store and maintain the first copy of this partition, and it will also fulfill all client requests for this partition. Similarly, the broker 2 is the leader for the second partition. Let's come to the next information. What is this? It is the list of the replicas. So, for the first partition, there are 3 copies. Broker 1 maintains the first copy, and this one is the leader also, right? Broker 2 manages second copy, and broker 0 holds the third copy. Broker 2 and broker 0 are the followers. Okay, what is this? The ISR. It is a list of in-sync replicas. You might have 3 copies, but one of them may not be in sync with the leader. So the ISR shows the list of replicas that are in sync with the leader. In our case, all 3 are in sync. Good. So that's it for this session. We covered replication and fault tolerance in this video. We also learned to start 3 brokers on a single machine. Hope you learned something. Please share your feedback. See you again in next session. Keep learning and keep growing.